course, can increase stress and lower your immune system. And did you know, and I know this might be shocking, and I definitely didn't get this much sleep in high school, but it's actually recommended that teens get 8 to 10 hours of sleep a night. So,
I'm going to bed tonight.
I'm going to go to bed now. Sleeping well lowers your chances of multiple illnesses, keeps you alert for important activities like driving, and when juggling everything, extracurricular activities like teen homework, this might seem really difficult. But a good amount of sleep can actually boost your performance in everything that you do when you're awake, and it makes those things even more enjoyable. Take into account the factors that may be keeping you from getting the right amount of sleep. Drinking caffeine late, not prioritizing our time well, or simply, and I know I'm guilty of this one, scrolling through your news feed while laying in bed. By getting your adequate rest, we also take care of our souls. We are less prone to sluggishness, anger, impatience, and a variety of other negative emotions. We are less likely to make poor decisions and to fall into sin. Furthermore, with adequate rest, our bodies and minds will be ready to enter into prayer. Think about, and I know I've done this too, how often you're almost on the verge of falling asleep when you're at prayer on Wednesdays, or while you're doing your night prayer before bed. They say that if you fall asleep while praying, your guardian angel finishes your prayers for you, but it's also good for us to finish some of our own prayers too. The Lord even rested on the seventh day of creation and commands us to do the same. Yes, he commands us to do the same. One of the Ten Commandments is to keep holy the Sabbath. The Catechism challenges us to protest against the servitude of work and the worship of money. So be a protester. Challenge yourself. Do your homework maybe or your chores on Saturday or Friday so that you can rest on Sundays. So I know this seems kind of a little teachy and a lot just because we're all sitting kind of separate and everything. And I don't want all of you to sit here and feel like as though we're saying whatever we're doing right now is all bad. It isn't. Like we said before, temperance is a virtue that we all need to pray for and strive for. But even in temperance, it isn't about restricting ourselves from things that bring us pleasure. It's making sure we're not always seeking what is pleasurable. It is saying, today I'm only going to play video games maybe for an hour instead of three. I'm only going to spend an hour on social media today instead of two. As we said before, we're meant to be in the world, but not of the world. Similarly, with rest, I know I often don't get the recommended hours of sleep by a long shot. But if I'm being 100% honest with myself, it isn't that I have to stay up because of commitments or anything like that. It's because of TV, my phone, wanting to hang out with friends or whatever. Which are all, of course, they're not bad things, they're good. But sometimes we need to take care of ourselves. So if that means saying no to plans or even missing life team events sometimes, we have to be willing to do those things for ourselves. But make sure we're also giving ourselves the proper rest. I also don't want you to sit here and feel like, okay, so to be a good Catholic, I need to eat healthy 24/7, maybe work out, look like a supermodel or bodybuilder. But honestly, don't let the devil lie to you right now. What Andy mentioned is eating good food to help fuel us, and moving our bodies around is good practice to remain healthy in order to honor the temples our bodies are. The reason I mention this is because of the culture, our society, and of our society, our bodies are often told, or we're told that our bodies are only good if we look a certain way. In thinking of all these things and all these ways to respect our bodies, there can be a temptation, though, to idolize our bodies, to get extremely wrapped up in how we look or what we're eating, simply to please ourselves or boost our image. The Catechism actually warns us against becoming overly preoccupied with physical perfection, because it can lead to the perversion of human relationships. We can become jealous of others or extremely prideful in our appearances. Holding our health, fitness, or beauty as an all-consuming idol can actually distract us from treating our bodies like the gifts they are in the temples of the Holy Spirit. Leading a healthy lifestyle should be an expression of virtue and gratitude. If we start to make healthy changes because we hate the way our body looks compared to others, then we don't actually have a healthy relationship with our body. certain teachings, like, oh, the body is a temple, and we need to, like, make it perfect or good. I think, well, no, we don't have to make it perfect. Remembering that it already is good, and that we're just doing things to help sustain that so that we're okay. But it's not what my mind ultimately jumps to. Instead of being healthy, is being thin. And instead of being healthy, is being, oh, like, restrictive or something like that. So we need to try to, like, what I'm working on is I'm learning that behavior. I've been trying this year a lot more to instead focus on why I'm doing what I'm doing. Am I trying to better myself because I don't like the way I look? Or am I trying to better myself because I want to be healthy? I want to play soccer with you guys. Maybe not. I don't love soccer, but maybe basketball more so. I want to play basketball with you guys outside. Or I want to be able to be healthy for my kids in the future. Or I want to, like, what is your why? But I think we need to realize that as a society, we pervert that why into just because we don't look right. There's no right, okay? We all are perfect in the way we're made, and I think that's what we heard from Patrick and Father Don last week, is we all have this dignity that can't be stripped away from us, and often, of course, our society is the one who's trying to strip that away, but I think sometimes we do it to ourselves. We're not honoring ourselves and who we are and our identity as a son and a daughter of Christ. Excuse me. And I think, too, with, obviously, I'm not going to sit here and go to social media as the root of all evil, which it might be a little bit, but whatever. But I think what we can do is we can use social media for good. So I focus on some of the accounts I follow. Like, I mean, I know we all do this, or on our Discover page, there might be people who are like, why don't we look like them? Why are they like this? Why can't I be like that? And it's like, you know what? Trying to fill our news feeds with people who bring us up and not tear us down. So whether that's following the Life Team account, or Elizabeth's new religious account, or following different people who are positive and awesome, like all of the people who, maybe Jacob, yes, Jacob raises him. Following Father Wayne, even though I don't think Father Wayne has an Instagram, but you can follow him, or a friend of mine. Instead of just following these accounts and looking at these things and thinking so negatively, try to fill your newsfeed, like I have tried, with things that bring you happiness and joy. And I think one last piece I want to mention about the rest thing. I think in America, we really almost pride ourselves in being like a work, like work, 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 work. I mean, what was that, Rihanna song? Whatever. But, so why do we praise people who work 60, 70, 80 hours a week? Like, and I think, obviously, maybe you're not there yet, but I know college applications. They want you to be the most involved student. They want you to do perfectly in all your courses. They want you to have extracurricular activities up the wazoo. So, like, they want you to basically work so many hours a week. And I think what we need to realize is it's okay to take a minute and to take rest. Like, I have said this before. Last week, I had this terrible headache. We went out to dinner after the Life Night. I, like, almost vomited at the halfway. You can ask Elizabeth. I don't know why. I just was not feeling well. And I realized, well, you know what? Amy, you haven't really been getting a ton of sleep lately, but you've been getting up to go to the daily mass. So what I did was I missed daily mass on Monday morning, and I slept in. And at first, I was feeling, like, very guilty about it, good old Catholic guilt. But then I realized, you know, sometimes it's okay to miss something like that, because what God wants more for us than necessarily making it to every single daily mass is He wants for us to be happy and healthy and be able to do the mission that He gives all of us to do every day. So, we must be a people of God, and as you mentioned, or as I mentioned, we're born with a dignity, and so therefore we need to treat our bodies with dignity. We're blessed with this body, and it does amazing things, and we need to take care of it. Through many things, of course, but not the least of this is through prayer to a God